starting lineups as Dale Brown has tried to get the right
free throw shooting, but yet he's so talented. He really makes LSU go. He's just an incredible player inside, just the entire key for LSU.
A junior.
That's the scary thing.
Isn't it, though?
He says he's going to complete his degree. Of course, he comes from an Army family. Matter of fact, he and Troy Smith played against each other many, many years ago, and he says he's going to complete his degree, so he's expected to be back.
O'Neal will step in, and the tip is controlled by Louisville. Everick Sullivan comes up with it, the senior starter at guard, over to Dwayne Morton. And Holden will take a three-point shot in and out. He was open for the shot and had the green light.
Yeah, LSU opened in a zone, and Holden took the shot and almost got it down.
He's capable of hitting from out there, even though he doesn't take many shots from that range. Here's the first turnover by LSU. Everick Sullivan stops and flanks it in.
Good start for Everick Sullivan. A lot of confidence on that bank shot.
So Louisville at 19-26 gets the first field goal. A high pass to Caesar in front court. Double team by Legree and Morton. Here goes the shot from outside, and the rebound is grabbed by Everick Sullivan.
Good position inside by Sullivan to get that rebound.
Here comes Legree. Nice pass to Miner on the baseline. But that is stuffed by O'Neal.
That's Shaquille's territory. You can't take it in there against the seven-footer.
And LSU throws it away. Second turnover, Louisville's ball.
You know, we didn't get a chance to talk a lot in the pregame about LSU facing the Louisville pressure. That's going to be something I know Dale Brown is very, very concerned with. Here you see the stuff by O'Neal, and Miner just couldn't get it past him.
Legree won't do it. He'll back out of there and then take the jump shot. Smart move by Legree, and Louisville leads 4-0.
And Keith has that bandage on his chin. He has six stitches when he fell on the floor at Freedom Hall the other night. Now O'Neal needs some help, and no one comes to his rescue.
That's twice now that O'Neal's tried to rifle one to get it on the inbounds, and twice he's thrown it away. Morton, no good with his first shot of the night. Dwayne Morton, as you pointed out, with that great, great game just this past week on Thursday night against that's out of bounds, so it'll be...
Well, they say that Louisville touched it last, evidently.
I was waiting to see as LSU steps out to take it and put it in bounds. Anderson in bounds. Singleton tipped up, and Morton will wipe the boards clean.
By the way, John Moreau, Stanley Raitt, and Stephen Gordon out of the ACC, the officials assigned to tonight's game.
Everick Sullivan against Caesar. Holden, AWOC, trying to put a move and get around the imposing O'Neal.
Just him being in the middle, and Denny Crum knows what a factor O'Neal is. It made Holden think about it, but he didn't take the shot. And again, LSU having trouble getting it in bounds, and now they'll bring it up against the pressure.
Louisville at the 17:49 mark leads LSU 4-0 here in Baton Rouge. Lobs it in, and O'Neal is fouled by Miner. Greg Miner picks up his first.
It's going to be interesting to see. Louisville has several options in defending O'Neal. Here you see, obviously, LSU wants to get it down on the baseline. Miner tried to front him, and there's no way you can front Shaquille O'Neal unless you got somebody on the backside, and Miner got that foul.
Deep to Singleton on the inbounds pass. LSU, as we played a couple of minutes here, 2.5 minutes, yet to score. And as Don pointed out in the pregame, they're going with that half court and deliberate offense.
Louisville with a little zone of its own here. The first time this year we've seen the zone of any circumstance.
Brandon throws it in. And LSU is in the scoreboard. Three to Holden. And now Morton back to Holden.
Part of the strategy to here is keeping Holden on a high post to keep O'Neal away from the basket, taking away his rebounding power.
Miner misfires, and O'Neal grabs it. Came right to him.
Didn't bother him anyway. And also, of course, he blocks shots when he's underneath the basket.
LSU down to Louisville 4-2 in the very early stages of the game here in the Maravich Assembly Center in Baton Rouge. O'Neal muscles his way in. He pushed. charge on Shaquille O'Neal.
Louisville in that zone again, once again sagging inside with Holden. Watch it here. Holden's on the backside. He now is getting some help side defense. Sullivan is there. No question, O'Neal with the offensive foul. He ran right into Everett Sullivan. Good job by the Louisville defense that time.
May be a concern to Dale Brown to see O'Neal get a foul so early in the game. 16 and a half minute mark. Holden blocked by O'Neal out of bounds.
He is so quick for a guy his size, and he's really firing up the LSU crowd. Not with his offense, but his defense. Watch him come up. Holden looks like he has the step, but no way.
Here's Miner. He'll put it up over O'Neal and hits. Three Cardinals have scored, Miner, Legree, and Sullivan, and it's 6-2 U of L.
Once again, O'Neal having trouble getting it in, and Cesar has to come to the rescue.
He deals it off inside. Shot is up, and it is good by Singleton. From the free throw line, open is Holden, and he missed. So Louisville's lead is cut to 6-4. Brandon kicks it outside. It's good. Three-pointer. Cesar.
LSU seems to like this fast pace. They've played it in years past, and, of course, they had 100 points in their last outing, so they like this up-tempo style.
Sullivan shot, and he's fired. Foul.
Well, you see, Sullivan going up for the shot. And Clarence Cesar right across the arm, and Sullivan will go to the line. Louisville has to take advantage of the free throw situation. When you're on the road, free throws are so, so important.
And Louisville only hitting 61% as a team. Everett Sullivan has been hitting just 68%. A concern for Denny Crum. That one rattled in, and that ties the game. It's 7-7 LSU and Louisville, and we'll be back.
It may surprise you to know that the largest oil spills are not from tanker accidents. They're from people changing their own oil and pouring it into the ground. Oil doesn't evaporate. It just sinks into the sewers and waterways. And one pint of oil can make a 1 acre slick on a lake or stream.
When you change your own oil, be sure to place the used oil in tightly sealed containers and call this number for the Hazardous Waste Program site nearest you. Earth Attitude is brought to you by WDRB-TV and Roman Haas, Kentucky.
Roman Haas has been part of the picture here since 1960. And while environmental awareness is new to some companies, it's the way we do business. We'll soon stop burning coal and reduce air emissions by more than 1,200 tons. We've developed ways to ship products in reusable totes and special trucks. And we sell tons of scrap plastic to customers who make new products. At Roman Haas, we see the big picture, and we're committed to doing more. Find out how by calling 449-5337.
Quality. It's not just a goal. It's a value embodied in everything we do in the pursuit of healthcare excellence. At Alliant Health System, total quality management means total satisfaction and total quality care for each and every patient of Norton, Cosair Children's, and Methodist Evangelical Hospitals. Putting quality first puts you first. Alliant Quality, making the very best even better.
Well, you can see the score. Louisville and LSU tied 7-7, 15:33 to go first half. David Sullivan and Don Russell with you from Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
David, Denny Crum's team with the up-tempo game has been able to get 10 shots off from the floor, but have connected on only three of those. LSU is 3 of 6. Coach Crum, of course, those impressive numbers. And another number he added was that 5-year extension to his contract, and everyone's very happy about that.
LSU gets it inbounds and comes on the attack. And the pace of this game has been in the favor of Louisville, a quick pace.
Louisville changing back to a man-to-man, showed a little bit of zone early.
Wide open for the shot from 3 points. That's Justin Anderson.
He's a transfer from Cal Irvine, and he's been moved to the off guard, had 16 points in the last outing for LSU, so they feel like he's really coming on.
So that three-pointer puts LSU in the lead by 3 at 10-7. Sullivan will fire a three, and he got it. That'll tie it back up. Now we're all locked up 10 to 10.
Everick appears to have that confidence in his eye tonight.
He's been hitting three-pointers at about a 37% clip. So both teams showing their ability to hit the deep shots. Shaquille threw that one up and banged it in.
Well, he had to touch on it. He is a huge, huge man.
That is his first points of the game. Now Miner for three. His eye is there. Holden with a rebound. Goes for the slam, and he's fouled. That's on O'Neal.
Well, Miner,
Caesar.
Miner did not really square up very well on that three-point effort. Took it a little bit early, and then on the rebound, Holden was there and tried to jam it back down. And LSU, without a doubt, is the most athletic team that Louisville has faced this year. It probably may be as good as they face all year. Caesar gets the foul as Holden can't get the jam job.
Holden goes to the line where he's hitting just 61%. Had his problems there this year, but he's very calm and methodical and perfect with that one.
You know, and Cornelius has been all around that career field goal percentage record for Louisville, but he's only shooting 47% from the floor this year.
Well, he's 50% tonight from the free throw line. That edges Louisville within a point. They trail 12-11. That's got a short Miner. Lead pass to Sullivan, collision, and the foul. So on LSU.
Sullivan had the right to go for that ball. Good hustle that time by Anderson, but Anderson, no question about it, David, made the contact.
That is the first on Justin Anderson. Watch it again.
Well, you see a looping pass up. Sullivan goes to get it, and Anderson is the guy that knocks him down and draws the foul.
Legree for three. Got it. And Louisville is into the lead. Legree with 5 points.
And O'Neal's the guy that takes it out of bounds against the press. LSU had a little bit of trouble with it earlier. Now they're beginning to settle down. And now they'll want to get it in the half-court game and try to get it into O'Neal.
Louisville with a two-point lead. 13-46, first half here in Baton Rouge. Shot is no good. And again, Louisville on the boards. Everick Sullivan with it. Legree stops and fires. It's no good. O'Neal will take the rebound. He'll dribble it over half court.
He needs help again.
And he throws it out of bounds. He's not getting the help he needs. Singleton.
And this is certainly not a knock against the All-American or Dale Brown, but I think you can see after that fifth turnover that Shaquille O'Neal is probably doing the right thing and staying in college basketball. He is learning more and more each year to gain composure. He's only 19 years old, and that's incredible, David. He's a very, very young player with a world of talent.
Everett Sullivan is no good on the shot, and O'Neal easily cleans the boards. 14-12, Louisville's leading by two. 13-03 first half. Three-point shot outside, no good. Whistle and a foul. Miner. And for Greg Miner, that'll be two. He's got both of Louisville's fouls in this early going.
You know, and there you have a situation now where it's going to be a free throw situation for LSU, but they'll get three free throws because he was fouled on the three-point effort. You want to get out and put pressure on the three-point shooter, but I think most coaches hate to see you foul somebody beyond that arc because it gives them three freebies.
Well, he failed to capitalize on his first freebie. They've got 13-01 to go in the first half. This game was tied at 7, and now it is 14-12 Louisville. Caesar makes it a 1-point Louisville lead. And the third free throw to tie it is Denny Crum, coaches minus.
Yeah, he's probably telling him, say, hey, guys, get out there, but we don't want to foul beyond that 3-point line.
13-minute mark. It's all tied up. 14-14, Louisville and LSU. Cardinals' second road game of the year. Sullivan with a pass to Holden, a beautiful play.
Boy, it was, because O'Neal came over to check Everick Sullivan, and Everick recognized it immediately, David. Perfect bounce pass to the corn man for the easy two.
16-14, Louisville by two at 12:30.
Of
no way to defend.
defend that.
Well, she's already brought one backboard to its knees already this year.
Here's Morton for two, and for Dwayne Morton, his first points coming off a 33-point game. And it is 16-18, Louisville. Off the break. Singleton, 4 points.
Singleton might be one of the most underrated players in the country. The senior from Natchez, Mississippi, has great jumping ability and really providing leadership for LSU.
Crowd is beginning to really pump up now as Morton is stuck. That was Caesar that came up with the stuff on Dwayne Morton. Holden against O'Neal. In the lane, over O'Neal, no good. A lot of guts by Holden to try that.
But he was thinking about it, you could tell. He knew O'Neal was there.
Here they go, O'Neal inside. Oh, and he is fouled by Cornelius Holden. Well, Louisville will probably pick up a lot of fouls trying to control O'Neal inside.
No question about it. There you see Cornelius Holden all over him, actually putting a little Santa Claus hold on our man Shaquille O'Neal. So that's where holding on Holden. And I would imagine, as you see Wingfield check in, you're going to have Cornelius Holden, Troy Smith, and even Brian Hopgood being in there at times to try to stop this big horse.
Shaquille O'Neal puts LSU in front 19-18. 11:25 here in the first half. 1 point lead for the Tigers as O'Neal hit one out of two. McGree and Sullivan are still in the backcourt. Very unusual to see a turnover by McGree. They're going to call a foul on Wingfield.
Yeah, Keith took it in traffic that time, David. You're right. He doesn't normally make mistakes like that, but he did that time, and a turnover, then a foul.
Timeout on the court. We'll be back to Baton Rouge in a minute.
I just love this new Diet Pepsi song, but do you think it's caught on yet? You got the right one, baby. You got the right one, baby.
With 100% Nutrisweet.
David Sullivan and Don Russell with you from Baton Rouge. A tight basketball game, a one-point LSU lead.
Great play here coming up by Everick Sullivan. You see him take it to the baseline. Now O'Neal will come over to help out, and then the nice pass over to Holden. So when O'Neal came up, that left Holden wide open. Now watch O'Neal. Everick Sullivan trying to check him here. He gets all by himself. Just throw it up near the hoop, and you can forget that, baby. LSU's a team, David. Look at that. They're talking about they need to beat a top 25 team, but look where they've done. They were in the preseason poll number 6, and they've gone down each week, and now dropped out of the top 25.
They got a 3-2 record. And Louisville, of course, at number 25 in the AP poll this week. The shot no good by Brandon. Rebound to Louisville as the Cards trailing by a point. Jermaine Wingfield throws it away. A turnover by Wingfield, and LSU with the basketball. Singleton does not drop, and Troy Smith now in the game at the rebound.
Great position by Troy Smith that time.
And Louisville turns it over again, throwing it away. Brandon. Here's Caesar to the baseline, shut off, and throws it away. So each team committing back-to-back turnovers. 10.5 minutes to go. LSU with 6 turnovers in U of L with 4. Outside, the three-pointer is good. So Sullivan has hit a pair of three-pointers. He's got 9 points. And there is another foul on Wingfield. That's two. He's picked up very quickly, Don.
Yeah, it is, and he was holding in the backcourt that time, and John Moreau quickly came over and detected that. Now we're going to get Brewer and Kip Stone into the lineup. Sullivan will get a rest, and Green will as well. So Denny Crum now has five players on the floor, none of which have started the game.
That's right. All the starters are now over on the bench getting a rest. Louisville leads us by two, 21-19. We were tied 7-7. Boudreau is in the game for LSU, number 32, as Caesar goes out. Here comes Williamson, another substitute. Driving layup is good. That is Maurice Williamson, who ties it at 21. So halfway through the first half, it's tied 21-21. Wingfield to Troy Smith. And we've got a foul on LSU, and that'll be on Williamson. So Williamson's first foul. Our next telecast will be coming up after the new year. Houston at Louisville. That's live Thursday, the 2nd of January at 8, WDRB. Here's a three-pointer, and it's good by Brewer. So James Brewer with a three-point shot. Louisville's on the lead by three, 24-21.
Louisville having a lot of success in that three-point shooting tonight.
We've had one by Legree, two by Sullivan, and now one by Brewer. So the Cards have hit 4 3-point shots in the first 10 minutes of the game. Lobbing it for O'Neal, knocked away on a nice defensive play by Wingfield.
Yeah, Tremaine was really fighting against O'Neal and created the seventh LSU turnover.
Hipstone, now Troy Smith left alone over O'Neal, got it. Troy Smith shows you that he can fire it up and hit.
You notice what the Louisville players are doing? They're going out on the high post, trying to keep O'Neal away from the basket, and he's not challenging him there outside.
They're grappling, and O'Neal gets the ball. Kip Stone went after it, and they're going to whistle a foul on Kip Stone. Number one on Stone, the sophomore out of Jacksonville, Florida. But what has happened here is Louisville has taken a five-point lead, 26-21, and we're inside 9 minutes to go. This game was tied at 21, tied at 18, tied at 14, tied at 7. Back and forth. A couple of substitutions now for LSU. Pugh is in. But O'Neal continues to play. He's played every minute so far. The only player on the court that hadn't had a break yet.
And he's in great condition for that, too.
LSU into the offense. Here's the lob. That's two dunks for O'Neal tonight. Gives him 17 on the season.
Denny Crum walking down his bench to talk to his players about where the breakdown was defensively that time. I'm not so sure it's as much of a breakdown as it is. You're just facing a great talent in O'Neal.
A Louisville by three, 26-23. 8 minutes, 23 seconds to go. Inside, Derwin Webb, and he will not hit it. Intimidated just by O'Neal's presence. But the pass is long, and Stone will have it, and Louisville will come back with the ball. Whips the pass over to Troy Smith. No good. Brewer tipped it, and he fouled. As Brewer and Pugh collided, they put the foul on Brewer.
Denny Crum was not pleased with that effort from Troy Smith. That's not the shot they wanted at all. You got some guys in the game like Brewer and Stone. They can shoot it from the outside. Troy has a good touch, but that was a shot that Coach Crum didn't want at all. After they picked up the turnover, brought it down on the break, it was an opportunity Troy could at least try to take it to the basket, and he didn't, and now the bonus situation for LSU.
That puts Pugh up to the line. T.J. Pugh, senior out of Baton Rouge.
You know, he started last year, David, had an SEC high 196 assists, which is the second highest single season total at LSU ever. This guy is a reserve now, so tell me Dale Brown doesn't have some depth.
He started three games this season, which is now in its sixth game for LSU. It's one of two, 26-24, Cardinals by two over the Tigers. 7:58, you see the clock ticking down in the first half. Louisville's had a five-point lead. Troy to Wingfield. He has it taken away, stripped by Pugh. And then Brewer knocks it out of bounds, but it's going to be LSU basketball. Stay with us. We'll be back in a minute.
Hamburger, soda, and fries.
It can happen to you at any moment, on any day, at any drive-thru.
Wrong again!
Try Rallies instead. If we don't get your order right, you get it free. No bombs in our bags. Rallies has it right.
Yourself.
The savings are incredible. Incredible. Incredible.
It's your Ford dealer's year-end clearance. Hurry in because time is running.
We got a two-point game here in Baton Rouge. David Solomon and Don Russell. And Don, I know U of L Athletics lost a very good friend this past week.
No question about it. Joe Kitchen, who is a 1961 U of L graduate, former basketball player, president of the L Club, very good friend of Denny Crum's, and a lot of people, died very suddenly last Thursday following the U of L game. And to his wife Blanche, his children, his family and friends, I know I speak for a lot of Cardinal fans, and our heartfelt thoughts and prayers are with you, Joe Kitchen. A great Cardinal player and fan, you'll be missed.
The clock here at LSU is at the 7:37 mark of the first half. LSU trails Louisville 26-24. This is Pugh. He can't get the shot and took steps. Brewer cut him off.
And LSU really having turnover problems. They have nine.
And now the AmeriCorps long-distance scoreboard. Arkansas has upended Arizona, 65-59. We'll have more in a minute. Troy Smith threw it away. More scores. You see Kansas, a future Louisville opponent. They'll meet them in January, handily beating Seattle Pacific. Indiana, a five-point win over St. John's this afternoon. Alabama beat Southern Miss by a bunch. A foul has just been called on Hanson. Mike Hanson in the game. You see West Virginia edging Virginia Tech. Southern Cal leads Ohio State by four. That's in the second half. And now back to action here. That was the AmeriCorps long-distance scoreboard. Louisville by two. LSU with the ball. 7:10 to go. Game has been tied several times. It's been close throughout this first half.
You mentioned Hanson. Mike Hanson's also a guy that started last year along with Pugh. He's a transfer from UT Martin and probably the best three-point shooter for the Tigers.
He's got it. Pugh will take the three. Three-pointer, and LSU has the lead at 27-26. 6:41 to go. Louisville firing and missed Pugh. Here's Pugh on the break behind the back. Singleton missed it. And Brewer will come up with the basketball. Out of bounds. Well, it is true that Denny Crum has kept his starters on the bench here for about 5 minutes.
Now he's beginning to make some moves. He's going to bring Sullivan up to the table along with LeGree and Morton. The guys that were in the game for Louisville did a good job, particularly on defense and with the tempo, but they didn't make much progress offensively. So Coach Crum now getting the starters back in, and they should be well rested.
He's got the entire starting lineup back into the game and not on the court. And O'Neal will inbounds the ball here. LSU leads Louisville 27-26. O'Neal needs help. Back court. Lead pass, Williamson got it over the line. Clock at 6:15, first half. That was a nice drive by Williamson. He's got 4 points, 29-26, LSU by three.
Well, he has great quickness, and he really, really is talented.
Holden thought about it, gives it over to Everick Sullivan, who wanted the three, and his lazy pass to Legree almost got him in trouble. Holden with a rebound and loses the handle on it. Picked up by Brandon of the Tigers. Hugh, he'll fire it. O'Neill not a factor under the boards. Ball is in the hands of Miner. Out of bounds to LSU.
Louisville did a good job defensively. Got the rebound and then lost it. Coach Crum wants good shots. If you can read lips, that's what he was talking about the offense there. He has not been real pleased with the shot selection here recently from Louisville. Now he has the starters back in. Maybe they'll get that continuity back that they had early in the game.
In this run, LSU has outscored Louisville 8-0. Make it 10-0. A two-pointer by Anderson.
Got to get out and get a hand in his face. This is a good three-point shooting team. LSU, that's been only 32% this year, but they're much, much better than that, especially here in the Death Dome.
Well, Louisville led by five, and now they trail by five. They've hit a drought. Holden over O'Neill. O'Neill got the rebound. He just calmly stands up above everybody and controls it.
He has six rebounds in the game here in the first half.
We hit the five-minute mark in the first half. LSU leading 31-26 after Louisville led 26-21. They have been outscored 10-0 by the Tigers in this stretch. They lob it to O'Neill, and he is fouled by Morton.
When he gets it in there, he has one thing in mind, and I mean go for the gorilla dunk. You see the little shove off there. O'Neill got away with one against Holden, and then the foul's on Morton. But at the beginning of that replay, it was very obvious. Different angle. Watch the shove off there. The Shaq got away with one there. Now he'll go to the line.
Where he has been for two opportunities tonight and is one out of two.
He just knocked Holden off like he was a little fly on his shoulder.
O'Neill now one for three as the Tigers lead by five over U of L, 31-26.
Second in career blocks in the SEC, 278.
He's two for four from the line, 32-26. LSU's outscored Louisville 11-0. Cardinals need a basket.
Yeah, they really do. They've been in a dry spell offensively.
Everick Sullivan is fouled. Williamson puts his hand up. His second. Dale Brown asking questions of the officials in a very calm way. This Pepsi preview reminding about the upcoming Lady Cards basketball all at Cardinal Arena. The second annual Sealback Classic after Christmas, the 28th and 29th. It'll be U of L and Hartford at 2 p.m. on Saturday, the 28th. And then Pitt, Texas Tech after that. Consolation game on Sunday, the 29th. Championship game at 3 o'clock. Everick Sullivan. 10 points by Sullivan. He's hit 2 three-pointers. That should give Sullivan 10 points, and O'Neill, the inbound with a press on by Louisville. He gets it over to Williamson. Williamson against Holden, lofts it up and got it. Williamson scored 6 points off the bench.
Yeah, this guy really has him in high gear when he takes it up the court.
Dwayne Morton has hit a cold spell tonight, 34-28 LSU. They go to O'Neill, turnaround off the glass, Holden with a rebound, and he'll protect it. Little trailing by six. Sullivan for three. That is three three-point shots that have gone up and in for Everick Sullivan in the first half. He's carrying the load on scoring, even though all five of the starters have scored, 34-31.
Louisville having more success with Sullivan outside than they are with anything else, any close, anywhere around the basket.
Brandon over Legree, short, and Holden takes the rebound. Picks it up over to Legree, 3:35 to go. And Morton, again, got it this time. Dwayne Morton with 4 points.
Squared up to the basket much better that time on the run. That was a better shot than the other one.
And when he starts to hit, you watch it, because Louisville's closed it down to a point lead now. 34-33 Tigers.
Of course, I think he really came into his own offensively in that tremendous game he had against Morehead State.
Here's a mismatch. O'Neal, he just shoved Everett Sullivan out of the way, but there was no call.
Danny Crum really wanted it. So did the entire coaching staff.
Well, O'Neal with just one. Here is a shot by Holden. And LSU, fast break the other way. They lose it. Hit a little rough the play here, a little ragged. Late stages of the first half. Sullivan tried to lob one to Morton, who wanted a foul and did not get the call. No call. Brandon blew an easy layup. Out of bounds, Louisville.
You know, Louisville's really done a good job on the backboards, David, particularly on the offensive end, and they've had some key defensive rebounds as well.
Step up to Save a Step, your convenience store that's a step ahead of the rest, featuring great holiday gift ideas. Delicious fruit baskets are now available at all Save a Step stores. Made fresh daily with assorted fruits and nuts. Small, $8.95. Medium, $10.95. Large, $16.95. Or treat the entire office to a customized order. Get your Save a Step fruit baskets today.
So we're enjoying our favorite spot.
Wow.
And we see this old guy.
Hey, Bob!
Then there was this huge wave. We thought the old guy was history. That was hot. Anyway, we were impressed.
Guru Dude, want a cold bud?
Groovy!
Groovy!
Despite our language differences, all surfers share a universal communication.
Oops.
Whoa.
Cardinal fans want to plan ahead. Louisville plays Xavier at Riverfront Coliseum on February the 8th. Cardinal Express package. It's $32. You get your game ticket, round-trip bus transportation, and a box lunch. Make your reservations. Call 588-5735. Just a game ticket alone is $12.50. That's coming up in February.
What a great game just up the road in the Queen City. A lot of fun. Good game, Louisville and Xavier. A lot of fans can be there. It's been pretty rough inside, David. Here you see O'Neal get it. Sullivan is there. Look to have the position. It looked like Shaquille used his left elbow to push off. No foul at all, but Louisville got the rebound anyway underneath.
Well, in the first half, Louisville's led by 5, 26-21. LSU came back to lead 31-26. Morton scores. Now it's 35-34. Louisville with a one-point lead. Just over 2 minutes to go here in Baton Rouge before a full house. On the floor, picked up and put in by Boudreaux, number 32. As Shaquille O'Neal is on the bench getting a rest here in the last couple of minutes. He comes off the bench right now. Sullivan spins loose inside and scores. Everett Sullivan is having a great first half. And Louisville leads it 37-36.
You know, it's been a fun game. It's been the pace, I think, favoring Louisville. I think what happened, though, is the bench strength for LSU is also showing up here in the first half. They played very well.
Thought about that three-pointer and backed off of it. 1:39 on the game clock, 25 seconds on the shot clock. And there's the three-point shot out of the corner that is good. Clarence Caesar. That's his second three-pointer. O'Neal waiting at the scorer's table when there's a break here to come back into the game.
He didn't get much of a rest over there, but they're going to try to get him in for the final minute or so.
39-37 LSU. Everett Sullivan stops and fires. It's no good. Miner trying for the rebound. Out of bounds. Louisville.
Yeah, I have no doubt Hanson touched it last. The students are out here at LSU. It's still a full house, but some of the students are still here. Dale Brown thought it should belong to his Tigers as well.
We have 16 points on our scoring here unofficially for Everett Sullivan in this first half. Shaquille O'Neal with three field goals. Two of them were dunks and two free throws, so he's got 8 points. So O'Neal offensively has not hurt U of L, but his presence in the middle is always a factor.
And he's been a demon on the boards as well.
Everett Sullivan. They called him for steps.
You know who was standing there?
Shaquille O'Neal.
Thank you very much.
He was thinking about what in the world am I going to do now?
Say a little prayer before you go up against him. You know there's only one guy that has averaged more shots per game in NCAA history. A guy by the name of David Robinson.
Impressive. 43 seconds, first half. 39 LSU, 37 Louisville. This has been a good, well-played first half.
Dale would like to run this down and take the final shot. He's going to have a little bit of time left on the game clock.
Go to O'Neal, picks it outside. Now here's Boudreaux driving over Morton. O'Neal now with 10 points, 41-37 LSU.
Get it to Everick Sullivan right here if you can.
They do, and he fires. It's off the mark. Troy Smith fires it back. Sullivan throws up another one off balance. No good. And so we'll go in at halftime with LSU leading Louisville. The Tigers 41, the Cardinals 37. And we'll be back with halftime activities here. Back here at LSU. Don't go anyplace. It looks like we're going to have a barn burner here. LSU by 4 over Louisville. Both teams had up to 5-point lead in the first half. And LSU on the attack early. Brandon breaks loose inside to score the first points. And LSU now with a 6-point lead. That's its biggest lead. And Louisville turns it over very quickly.
You know, we talked about in our Budweiser game plan about the scoring balance for LSU. And I think Dale Brown's beginning to get more of that in tonight's game. And then Louisville just committed the first turnover in the second half. And now LSU has a chance to open up some breathing room.
There's Hole or Miner that commits the foul. And that'll be three on Greg Miner. Three personal fouls on the sophomore out of Sandersville, Georgia. Miner had 2 points in the first half. But very quickly picks up the third foul.
It's a big possession here for LSU. They can really get in a position where if they want to control the tempo, they can if they get a basket here.
O'Neal working to get the ball, bounces it back, and here is the shot, no good. Back to O'Neal, turnaround over Holden, it's good. O'Neal with 12 points, LSU by 8.
Louisville did a poor job of going after that loose ball off the glass that time, and as a result, LSU got the second opportunity, and O'Neal made the most of it.
Tigers' biggest lead, 8 points, 45-37. Here's Legree with a turnover. And two turnovers tonight by Legree. Very uncharacteristic. Brandon hits the shot. And just like that, LSU has a 10-point lead. 47-37.
Cardinals really sluggish to begin this second half, and Brandon once again almost took it from Legree, but he does get the foul this time. And Brandon is the guy that in this half, David, has created it, particularly with his defense for Dale Brown.
Well, LSU has come out red hot. They've outscored Louisville out of the gate here, 6-0. They lead 47-37. Brewer is in. Derwin Webb has come off the bench for U of L. Everick Sullivan is out of the game, along with Miner with three fouls. Morton beating Brewer over O'Neal. That was an impressive move by Brewer.
Yeah, and Boo comes right into the game and gets into the flow of the offense.
Well, that cuts LSU's lead back to 8. There's Morton working the defense on Brandon. Lane Morton plays very aggressive defensively. Here's the turnover. Morton goes for it, but could not come up with it. They got O'Neal giving a screen to Singleton, and he can't get it to roll. Morton will recover it after being knocked outside by Holden. And the fast break, Louisville. Here's Holden in the lane over O'Neal, gets the basket. 5 points, Cornelius Holden. Louisville pulls within 6, 47-41.
And that was a big possession, big conversion by Louisville. Now they'll get the turnover.
And Holden will take the jumper. Ill-advised shot. It's a 6-point game, 17-40 to go. Anderson and Singleton exchange the passes.
They're really looking to get it to O'Neal.
Brandon misfired a three, and there's O'Neal. Shaquille O'Neal playing cleanup. 49-41.
I think it's really important, Dave, that when Louisville denies the ball to O'Neal on the offense and somebody else takes the shot, they got to get that rebound if O'Neal doesn't, because once they give him an opportunity to get the ball down low as a follow-up, he's impossible to stop.
Now the Cardinals.
Don't hold the cutter.
Watch the shot clock move inside 25 seconds as they trail the Tigers by 8. Trail them by 4 at halftime. Holden. Derwin Webb has it blocked. Here's Holden. Bounce pass on the side by Webb. Good play. Derwin Webb, 49-43. Louisville them 6.
And that was the perfect pass there. Had it not been a bounce pass, O'Neal would have been able to get his hand on it. So that was a great pass by Holden that time.
Dale Brown looking on. Shot. Singleton follows and misses. They're hacking underneath, and the foul is called. Holden. Cornelius Holden, I believe, will get the foul. Number 2 on Holden.
Another example of not being in position to get the defensive rebound. And as a result, it was not O'Neal that got any involvement at all into that flow, but yet Singleton who did a good job on the offensive glass. This LSU team is very, very talented. I think a lot of people lose sight of the fact that they were the co-champions of the SEC last year and now are picked along with Arkansas pretty much to be the favorite in the SEC Western Division.
Well, Singleton missed his first free throw. One out of 2, 5 points for Nell Singleton. And LSU 50-43, up by 7. Just over 16 minutes to go. LSU's biggest lead this half, 10 points. Troy Smith to Legree. Fall away jumper. Kind of off balance, not a good shot perhaps, but Louisville will keep it. 16:03 to go in the game. Everett Sullivan is still without a point this half. Here's Webb, and they put him inside. Loose ball, Troy Smith. Goaltending, that'll be a good basket by Troy Smith.
You know, that's about the first time we've gotten any reaction out of Dale Brown. He's been rather sedate. Of course, he's mellowed over the years, but he didn't agree with that call at all, and it looked like a pretty good defensive play to me.
We'll be back after this break.
We may not know who's been naughty or nice, but we do know you'll love holiday gifts at the Walmart price, like Cody gift sets. For her, the exclamation gift set and the Lady Stetson gift set, just $10 each. For him, your choice of 2 Stetson gift sets, just $10 each. For gifts at a price that's always nice, Walmart. Always the low price. Always.
It's the Dodge Drive for the Gold sales drive. Now own Shadow America for only $69.84 thanks to $1,000 cash back. On Caravan, get $500 cash back, and you can get air at no extra charge. Up to $2,000 cash back on select Dodge trucks and package savings up to $26.83.
Stop by and see one of the 5 Kentuckiana Dodge dealers today.
Think you're too busy to work out? Then you're probably the person who needs it the most. Regular workouts reduce stress and add years to your life. Busy, I know. Just give me 15 minutes and I'll give you the express workout and a new lease on life. We'll even take care of your kids. Stressed out? Come on, work it out with us at American Fitness Center. Introducing the $19 month-to-month plan. Only $19 per month for as many months as you choose. But hurry, offer ends soon.
Let's look at that block just a minute ago. Goaltending call against Shaquille O'Neal.
David, looked like to me that this ball was not on its way down. Particularly when we watched it the first time, even without the benefit of the replay. But O'Neal, who can really get up, they gave him the goaltending call, so that pulled Louisville back within 5.
They've been down by 10. Here's Brewer knocking it away. Morton missed the shot, but a foul is called, and it's going to go against Caesar, I think.
Tell you what, He can get up as well. Watch this.
O'Neal got the foul. Shaquille O'Neal.
Here's the Brewer steal. Morton picks it up. And right across the arm and also across the face of Dwayne Morton. No question that was a foul.
So O'Neal picks up personal number two. 15:56 to go in the game. And Morton converts. 7 points now for Dwayne Morton.
Dwayne wanted to send his love back to his mom, Charlotte, and also his sweetheart. He wouldn't tell me who it was. You know, he said in the media guide that his most proud achievements are what he's done on the basketball court and his love for his mother, and I guess during the holiday season, to hear that from a young man that's down here in Baton Rouge playing in a big game, say, make sure you say something to my mom. That means a lot.
Two for two. Very calmly, he hits, sinks them both, and Louisville is within three at 50-47. So Louisville has cut the 10-point LSU lead down to three. Brewer on Brandon. Brandon drives around him into the lane. Foul is called. The whistle. So Brewer, his second personal, and Brandon will be at the line for two. Brandon scored 4 points early, and that's part of the second half that kind of took that four-point lead and expanded it for LSU.
Yep. He was a former Mr. Basketball in Illinois, played at Martin Luther King High School in Chicago, and is a Prop 48 casualty, but what a great talent he is.
Dale Brown always recruiting great talent here.
He's never lacked for players. Just think if Jackson was still around.
Missed the second one. Legree has Brewer. Followed by Smith, no good. Brewer has it blocked by O'Neal, and a foul is called. And that is Shaquille O'Neal. Three fouls.
Boy, what a great, great play that was. First of all, the pass by Legree. Anybody else on the floor had no idea. But you see, Brewer just missed the good reverse. Webb kept it alive, and now Brewer takes it back and might have initiated that contact, but I think what happened was the big guy O'Neal took the swat at it, and now he's going to go to the bench with three personal.
So mark it down that O'Neal went out at 15:29, and here is Brewer. Boy, it has been a tough season for U of L at the free throw stripe. Brewer's been hitting 75% as you look at that foul again.
Yeah, one more time. Still going to be a foul on O'Neal, however you look at it, I guess. And Dale Brown talking to his franchise over there. And you can see O'Neal has 14 points and a bushel full of rebounds as well. 10 and about four block shots.
Oh, Brewer hit one out of two. 51-48. Louisville is down by three. We got a foul on Derwin Webb. Well, marked down that it was a three-point game when Shaquille O'Neal went to the bench with his third foul. See if Louisville can make some headway here with O'Neal out of the game.
They're also doing it with Holden over on the bench along with Miner and Sullivan.
There's Derwin Webb with a nice steal. Over to Legree. Legree lost the handle. He's in trouble tonight. Brewer for three-pointer. Got it. That's a second three-pointer for Brewer. 51-all. It's tied.
Who's done a good job. He's two for two from three-point land and done a good job defensively, as did Derwin Webb with that great effort on that last possession to get the steal.
Players coming off the O'Bell bench playing well. Brandon misses. Caesar with a rebound. It's out of bounds. LSU gets the ball. And O'Neal is back into the game with three fouls. 14:49 to go. And Shaquille comes back.
And Williamson comes along with him, David. We saw him in our highlight package at the intermission.
Overtime, Ohio State and Southern Cal on our AmeriCall scoreboard. Basket is good. O'Neal, 6 points this half, 16 in the game.
Took him 2 seconds to score.
Brewer comes back and scores. James Brewer. 8 points in the half for Brewer, 11 in the game.
four out of five from the floor. Boo doing a good job, a real contribution tonight here in Baton Rouge.
When he's hot, he can really help you. Inside O'Neal for the jam. Well, they're going to get everything out of O'Neal they can. 18 points for Shaquille. Here goes Legree, kicks it out. They're going to get Brewer the shot, but a whistle inside. Holding foul. And that's on Brandon, number two.
You know, you're looking at Denny Crum and now Dale Brown. And, David, these are two of only 15 coaches that have been at the same Division I school continuously for 20 years. And is this guy, he might be 19, but he's no question a man among boys on the court.
Brewer, three-pointer, got it. Well, Brewer is having one of those nights. 55-56, LSU down by a point. As Louisville has the lead. They trailed by 10 in this second half. Brewer hammered him.
Whoa.
And now we got a problem.
Yep.
Brewer. That's what he'll do.
Dale Brown now is getting a little bit animated. He wants an intentional foul. Now Denny Crum is getting into the air. And he's really upset. Now Dale Brown just thrown his jacket. The return of the old Dale Brown. It didn't take much to light his fuse, but
now,
that was not an intentional foul.
Denny Crum goes over to talk to Dale Brown and get him off the court. He has no business being out there, quite frankly.
Yeah, Dale Brown, Denny Crum won't back down from that guy one bit.
Well, they exchange words, and Dale whipped that jacket off quickly and got back to the bench.
Let's see what happened. You see the foul coming up, Brewer. And then the shove, actually the grab by Williamson into Brewer. Everybody seemed to be okay till Williamson came in there. And now they're going to have to sort this all out. And then Dale Brown comes in and shows his emotion as he normally does. He's not supposed to leave the bench at all. And of course, they have put in some NCAA rules about leaving the bench. And Dale Brown in just a moment will throw his jacket off. And that's the old Dale Brown, my friends.
Well, he could have been hit with a technical for what he did, too.
That was not an intentional foul. I mean, it was a hard foul, but there was nothing at all. Matter of fact, if anything at all, it looked like Brewer was trying to catch the LSU player. Let's see what you think, David. Look, there's an obvious foul here, but watch Brewer. He tried to break his fall a little bit. He didn't sling him down. And then it was Williamson was the guy that got into the act for some unknown reason, and then Dale Brown beginning to show his true colors.
And there you have a conference that's been going on at center court between the coaches and the referee. Dale Brown is asking his team to come over to the bench.
And I think they want both coaches to talk to their team and try to settle things down here a little bit. But I don't think anybody was upset until Williamson got into the act.
Well, both teams go to their respective benches, so whatever the words that came from the referee, Stephen Gordon, have been given to Crum and Brown, and now they are talking to both of their squads.
It's cooling off period.
All right, the situation is not an intentional foul on James Brewer, but a foul, a personal foul. And the officials have asked the coaches to talk to their teams, calm them down.
You know, it's been about 70 degrees outside today. It's hot here in the Maravich Center tonight. A near-capacity crowd. Matter of fact, Dale Brown's going to settle down and put his jacket back on.
Well, look, Louisville has the lead at 56-55 after trailing by 10 points. And now the foul shot by Singleton. He'll get another one. He's one for three tonight at the line. Has 5 points, one rebound. A senior out of Natchez, Mississippi. He missed both of them, and Morton's got the rebound for Louisville.
You know, I think the officials did a good job of handling that situation, David.
It could have gotten out of hand very, very easily. You're right.
And they didn't throw anybody out, and I don't think they really needed to. There was no punches thrown or anything like that.
Morton is trying to get open, and Brewer wanted to get it to him, but couldn't. Derwin Webb. Troy Smith inside Brewer, or Morton turnaround. O'Neill with a rebound and the fast break on the way. The Williamson. '57-'56 LSU. Brewer missed the three. O'Neill off the back and out of bounds of Justin Anderson.
You know, he went from one terrific outlet pass that led to the dunk to an absolutely horrible outlet. And Denny Crum trying to settle his team down a little bit. I'm a little surprised we haven't seen Sullivan back in the game. He didn't do some things very early in the second half, but he's been on the bench for a while as well. But I tell you what, Brewer's doing a heck of a job, and he may need a blow here pretty soon, or maybe Legree.
Louisville will put it in play. Brewer in front of the Louisville bench. 41 seconds on the shot clock. 57-56 LSU. 13 minutes to go in the game. Offensive foul is called on Derwin Webb. That's his second.
We
are trying to get another foul on O'Neill.
No question about it. And you know what's going to happen now, David? You're going to see this game being called very close to the vest. Earlier in this game, that would have most likely been a no call, but they're not going to let anything that would come close to generate maybe a spark or two from this team get out of hand now.
Louisville has had a one-point lead in this half after trailing by 10. LSU now with a one-point lead. Singleton almost lost it off his hip. Points in the half, 20 for the game. Shaquille O'Neal. LSU by three. Morton driving, got the basket and the foul on Shaquille O'Neal, number four.
You can't tell anybody what a big, big play this is, David, because not only did the basket count for Louisville, but they got the big guy now with four, and give Derwin Webb credit for the pass, and Morton using his body to shield the Shaq away, and now he'll have a chance to tie the game.
Well, another seven-footer will come into the game. Geert Hammack out of the Netherlands, as the crowd gives quite an ovation for Shaquille O'Neal, who goes to the bench with the four personal fouls.
Hammack may be 7 feet tall, but he is no Shaquille O'Neal. I promise you that. There's not many players like that young man.
And now Dwayne Morton will try to make this a three-point play, and he does. Morton with 4 points and a half, 10 in the game. Brewer knocks it away, out of bounds, LSU ball.
I just can't emphasize enough how well Brewer has played and really lifted this team in the second half, David, when they needed the spark. Did you notice it that way?
Exactly. Brewer has hit the shots. Williamson, wild pass. Hammack has it outside. Anderson over here, number five, begging for the ball. Was wide open, wanted to take a three. They didn't get it to him. There's a three, Williamson. Williamson with 5 points and a half, 11 in the game. 62-59 LSU by three. Everett Sullivan, who's back in the game. Here's Troy Smith between the legs, but Morton recovers nicely. 11:38 to go, LSU by three. Sullivan, Troy Smith, and he does not get the basket, but he's fouled. And the foul on Hammack, number one on him.
I don't think there's any doubt that Louisville now is going to try to get an inside game going with the Shaq over on the bench. If you joined us late, he's had a great night, but he also now has four personal fouls with 11:30 left. But I think Louisville will continue to try to take it inside here and take advantage of the fact that O'Neal's over on the bench.
Troy Smith will have two. And hitting just 33%. Got that one. 5 points tonight by Troy Smith. He hits both of them. It's a one-point LSU lead. back to Baton Rouge after this.
Great Financial Federal.
You build a team with talent, build it solid, make it hum, and you build a winning program for all the years to come.
Great Financial Federal, your key to financial security.
Guys, it doesn't get any better than this.
Walt Smith was wrong. Because when Muskrat Mike discovered gold, it got somewhat better. And when the Swedish bikini team came downstream, it got a little better. And when reinforcements of Old Milwaukee arrived, it most certainly got better. Old Milwaukee and Old Milwaukee Light. It just doesn't get any better than this.
This Pepsi preview to remind you of the combination ticket package available now. You can purchase a Metro tournament ticket and then have the opportunity to buy seats for any of the last seven Cardinal basketball home games. The Metro tournament men and women's basketball championships at Freedom Hall, March the 11th through the 15th. For information on the three seating plans, 588-5151. That'll be some great basketball at Freedom Hall as the Metro tournament comes to Louisville.
Yep, of course, both the men and women, as you mentioned, David. In this game, three-point shooting. LSU, 5 of 11. Louisville, 7 of 13. Sullivan's hit 3 out of 5. Brewers, 3 of 3.
Averick Sullivan has not scored tonight in the second half. Hit 16 in the first half. Kentucky early. One-point lead on Georgia Tech at the Omni in Atlanta. More are on our AmeriCall scoreboard. Ohio State loses by 1 in overtime to Southern Cal. Here is a foul, offensive or not, on Williamson. No, it is called on Boudreaux. That's number one on Boudreaux.
But I think that puts Louisville in the bonus situation, David.
Seventh team foul, you're right, on LSU. So Brewer will go to the line. He just hit 2 out of 2. 1 out of 2, excuse me, as Brewer's canned a total of 3 three-pointers tonight. 75% free throw shooter. Singleton is back. Vernell Singleton comes in. Boudreaux, who just picked up the foul, exits. Shaquille O'Neal still on that LSU bench.
Now that's the decision Dale Brown has to make, is how long he keeps Neal over on the bench with 4 fouls.
Louisville back in the lead, 63-62. 11-16 to go. Cardinals trailed by 10 early in this half, but have now got a one-point lead. Singleton hits the shot, fouled by Troy Smith. That's one on Smith.
Singleton's done a good job in this game for LSU. You see the reach in and the little finger touch by Smith, but that's a foul. And Denny Crum really has a small but quick lineup with Smith, Morton, Sullivan, Legree, and Brewer, his lineup. Of course, he can afford to do that when you have O'Neal over on the bench with 4.
Rebound, bad mistake by the Cardinals to let Williamson come in and swipe the rebound after the missed foul shot.
That's happened several times. You got to get those loose balls like that.
Well, it didn't hurt him because LSU turns around and throws it away. Tigers by 1, 64-63. 11 turnovers by LSU. Here's another turnover for Louisville. Tigers with it on the run. Brandon. He's fouled. No basket, as it was no good. So Legree, his first foul. Brandon, number 4, at the line. Jamie Brandon. 7 points. Ready, gives LSU a two-point advantage, 65-63.
You know, against Southwest Louisiana, last outing, this guy had 14 points. He was 4-for-4 in three-pointers, 8 assists, the block, and 3 steals.
66-63, LSU by 3. 10:34 to go. Louisville works it in. This is Troy Smith with the ball. He walked. No, they call a foul. Outside. They're in the bonus.
But you notice that Louisville's just not as comfortable in the half-court game. I mean, they're not doing a bad job with it at all, but I think you can see that in that half-court game, they're just not real sure about things at times. You're going to see the foul come in. Away from the ball, actually. I think Morton's the guy that'll go to the line. He is.
Well, Morton 3-for-4 there tonight. He's done well. Louisville trailing by 3. 10:19 to go here in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. As another one coming. Louisville cuts it to 2.
You know, that great game that Morton had against Morehead State, he came into tonight as the top scorer average-wise for Louisville.
Averaging 15 points a game. Now we're a one-point game. LSU 66-65. Here's the press. And Brandon breaks it quickly in the front court.
He's solid, isn't he?
Here we have Sullivan out on Anderson. Sullivan has not scored in the second half after 16 in the first half. Louisville is still in this game. Here's Anderson with a head fake. And Morton will pick up the loose ball off Hammock. 17 turnovers. Here's LeGree, a great pass to Smith for the jam.
Boy, that was nice. Keith with the penetration and with O'Neal on the bench. Enabled Louisville to get the easy 2.
And Louisville has the lead by 1, 67-66. 9:33 to go. As we have lead changes throughout this half. Williamson over to Hammock, and he's got it knocked away, and Everett Sullivan has it for Louisville. Cardinals in the front court. Sullivan bounced past Brewer. He's been hot for 3. But Smith... Boy, they're fighting for the ball. It's loose, and Brewer. There's LeGree. Rifles a pass to Morton. They're just going in and throwing dunk up after dunk. And the foul on Hammett. The basket by Troy Smith.
Yeah, Dale Brown's not going to waste any more time. He's going to bring O'Neal back into the lineup for Hanson. But Louisville did a great job on the offensive boards that time. Here you see LeGree with the pass. Morton actually should have had this. He just missed the dunk. Smith does get the follow, gets the benefit of the block call. The basket will count, and he'll go to the line, and the Shaq is back.
This is the biggest lead for Louisville in the second half. 3 points, 69-66, 9:03, and Troy Smith can make it a three-point play. He's got 10 points. Make it 11. And Louisville by 4 at 70-66. And O'Neal with 4 fouls is back in there in the middle. And got Morton guarding him. Now they got 3 men on him, and he goes up to the basket and scores. 22 for Shaquille.
He gets it in that position, and he's so strong, and he has such a nice touch around the basket. You just can't stop it. You got to hope that nobody else really hurts you too much, and maybe in this case, O'Neal will get his 5th foul.
8.5 minutes left to go. Here's Troy Smith, and it's blocked by O'Neal. LeGree has it stripped away by Williamson. 70-70.
See, that shows you the impact of O'Neal. He scores, and then he does something with his defense.
Troy Smith over him this time, scores over O'Neal.
He backed off a little, didn't he?
13 points for Troy Smith. Louisville 72-70. They've got 8 minutes even to go. Hanson, a 3-pointer in and out. O'Neal.
Well, that could have been his 5th foul right there.
He dishes it off. The shot is no good, and the foul on Morton.
I thought there was a case there where O'Neal was being very, very dangerous with his fifth personal foul. Here you see after he gets the rebound, but prior to that, could have been a little push-off. Doesn't get the roll, but Singleton will go to the line.
Substitute for Louisville is Holden. Troy Smith goes out. Miner is back into the game.
Now there you see. See, he puts himself in that position. Looked like it was clean. But boy, that's just very dangerous. Sometimes you don't get the benefit of playing cleanly, trying to get the rebound, but he was there.
Singleton with two. He's one for four.
Nice to tell him.
72-71. Louisville's lead at one.
It's been a great game, hasn't it?
It has. It certainly has with 7:46 left. LSU had a 10-point lead early in this second half. Louisville has been up by four this later part of the half.
This is a place where they were 15-1 last year, and they've won 24 of their last 25 games in this building. Tough place to play.
We're tied.
Reputation for quality, second to none. And a desire to make it even better. Introducing the men and women of Toyota Motor Manufacturing in Georgetown, Kentucky. They just couldn't leave well enough alone.
Listen up! I'm not here to babysit your panty waist. I'm here to make you better Nintendo players.
So what does Mario do here?
Mr. Jackson?
Wrong. Wrong.
Do a little dance.
Wrong.
To get better at Nintendo, pick up super secret game tips on packages of Pepsi. Best of all, you can win one of thousands of Super Nintendo entertainment systems delivered via Federal Express.
Bo, I want you in my office now.
This kid's an animal.
You could win Super Nintendo with Pepsi.
This game summary is being brought to you by Old Milwaukee and Old Milwaukee Light. It doesn't get any better than this. Eric Sullivan carried the load in the first half for U of L with 16, and in the second half, Brewer with 13. O'Neal has been dominating, as expected, 22 points and 13 rebounds, 5 blocks, but his fourth foul came in the second half with a lot of time to go, and LSU had a 12-0 run in the first half. This game summary has been brought to you by Old Milwaukee and Old Milwaukee Light. Doesn't get any better than this. We're tied. It's 72-72 at the Pete Maravich Assembly Center in Baton Rouge. And this is Shaquille O'Neal. This game is going to go right down to the wire.
Yeah, you're talking about things being good and nothing better than this. Nothing better than this matchup down here in the Bayou.
They got Holden in, and Kip Stone has joined the Cardinals on the court in the backcourt. Everett Sullivan, and they throw it away. Morton threw it away, fast break, Singleton. O'Neal, he almost crashed the backboard.
Really?
Miner rifled a perfect shot to Sullivan.
Boy, what a nice pass from Greg Miner, and he's been really quiet tonight here in LSU.
He scored 2 points. 74-72, Louisville up by two. 7:05, and the clock running. The lob, but did not work. Now they got Kip Stone out ahead of the bunch. Kicks it back, Everett Sullivan for three. Five quick points by Everett Sullivan. Timeout, LSU. And it's a 5-point Louisville lead. 6:49 to go. Stay with us.
Your Lincoln Mercury dealers are proud to be a sponsor of the Louisville Cardinals and proud to introduce our starting lineup for 92. Mercury Grand Marquis, still America's true full-size sedan. Mercury Sable, smoother, quieter, more comfortable. The 92 Tracer, the new small Mercury that's big on value. See our entire lineup today and go Cards!
We're bringing you Cardinal Power.
Most pregnancy tests have the same problem, little cups.
You gotta be kidding.
But Clear Blue Easy is just one piece, one step. No little cups to fill or spill. Give up the cup. Try Clear Blue Easy. It's one step easy.
You have a cold.
Yes, I do.
Here's two cold medicines. This relieves these three symptoms, this nine. Choose one.
Nine.
You chose Dristan Cold over Sudafed. Try it.
The Dristan really worked.
Dristan, the face of relief today.
All right, let's run lead. See what happens. Turn it over now. Execute. Money. Don't be damn addicted.
All right, Denny Crum sends him out back on the court with a five-point lead. Louisville 77, LSU 72.
You know, one of the things he said during the break that we eavesdropped on was the fact that everybody's a rebounder. And that's very, very important in the last 6:49. Every rebound is crucial.
Everett Sullivan with five this half, 21 in the game. He, Brewer, and Troy Smith, all in double figures, have carried the scoring load for the Cardinals tonight against LSU. Shaquille O'Neal continues to play with four personal fouls. This is a three-pointer and no good, as LSU has gone cold from the outside. Holden did not try to take it inside on O'Neal.
He did not, and he didn't even think about shooting out there. Denny Crum wants the alley-oop.
And he got it. Over O'Neal to Everett Sullivan. My goodness.
Great play. Great execution.
79-72, Louisville by seven. 6:09 to go. This is U of L's biggest lead in the game. And it's come with O'Neal in the game. That's a three-pointer, though, by Singleton.
Yeah, Denny Crum's really upset that they didn't extend that defense out. He's yelling out at Dwayne Morton. Louisville was in a zone, and they want to make sure they don't get uncontested perimeter shots like that.
Kip Stone, he handles the ball to Holden, and they launch one over almost out of the reach of Morton. Dwayne Morton with a move on Singleton, and it's blocked by O'Neal. His perimeter of effectiveness is just about anywhere.
Yeah, it is. And that time he came from the help side defense, and you're going to see his sixth rejection of the game, and he knocked that one over to Shreveport.
The Cardinals' credit, they keep coming at him. Morton is fouled. He wanted to get the foul on O'Neal. He didn't. Look at some other scores on our AmeriCall long-distance scoreboard. Kentucky in a close game, leading Georgia Tech by two in the first half in Atlanta. The final score in overtime, Southern Cal clips Ohio State 79-77. Morton missed. Little with a four-point lead, and Morton makes it five as he hits that second one. 80-75, 5:22 in Baton Rouge.
Let's see what Louisville does defensively. They've been playing a zone, and Coach Crum really wants to extend that zone. Looks like they're showing a little zone right here. They are indeed.
Singleton for three. Back-to-back three-pointers by Caesar.
Once again, that same spot on that left wing, and he likes it.
And we got a two-point game, 80-78. Caesar, 50 to go.
Four out of six in three-pointers.
Sullivan missed one. Holden rebound over O'Neal. Tried to get the foul, and he did. Good night, Shaquille.
Yeah, that could make a huge difference in this ball game. O'Neal, Holden fake. And finally, the Shaq man is gone. Hammock will come back in, but O'Neal will get a standing ovation. I'll say one thing, David. Louisville has done this. They have challenged O'Neal. And as a result, he's gone with 4:42 left.
Timeout, LSU. We'll be back. Stay with us.
Quality. It's not just a goal. It's a value embodied in everything we do in the pursuit of healthcare excellence. At the Women's Pavilion of the Northern Hospital, quality means the most advanced maternity care in the region. But it also means sensitive, personalized care, comfortable rooms, and of course, unforgettable moments. Alliant Quality, making the very best even better.
You know when it's right. You know when you feel it, baby. You hold it, you hear it, you taste it, it's right. Passably callable and intimately soulful. You got the right one, baby.
With 100% NutraSweet.
Louisville by two, 4:42 to go. Shaquille O'Neal has fouled out.
This is our candidate, at least one of them, for the Papa John's play of the game, depending on the result. Might have been a little reach in earlier, but when they called the foul on O'Neal, well, what we said earlier, different angle, I think you're going to see the same results. Anytime you have four personal fouls and you put yourself in a position to try to block a shot, you take a chance of getting that fifth foul, and that's what happened to O'Neal. He's gone.
With 22 points and a very productive night. But now he will sit on the LSU bench and watch the last 4 minutes and 42 seconds, his final numbers. 14 rebounds, 6 block shots.
What a different team LSU is with him in the game and with him out of the game, too. But yet, you know, they played well even when O'Neal had to go to the bench. But now it's going to be more of an even match. You don't have one superstar that can dominate a segment of the game.
Holden's foul shot. Louisville by three, 81-78. Holden has not scored a lot, but he was able to get O'Neal out of the game, missing that second one. 3-point lead, LSU basketball. Louisville had a 7-point lead at 6:09, 79-72.
Now with O'Neal out, let's see if Louisville stays in the zone. They are, but they need to extend. Denny Crum doesn't want the uncontested three-pointers. He wants them to shoot from the perimeter, though.
Brandon on the drive has a shot rejected by Holden. Here's Louisville. Threw it away.
Skip left his feet, David. The cardinal sin. No pun intended.
Williamson driving over the outstretched arms of Holden.
Oh, Morton got buried. I mean, Williamson, and Morton's really been out of shape, and I don't blame Dwayne Morton. Williamson shoved Morton down to the ground trying to get that loose ball. That's incredible. And Denny Crum's yelling out to Kip Stone to keep your feet on the floor. Now watch Williamson here. Scramble for the loose ball, and he just jumped on top of Dwayne Morton. Now you tell me that's not a foul. Give me a break.
LSU ball, they're down by three with just over 4 minutes to go here in Baton Rouge. Singleton for two. Hammett got the rebound and he's fouled.
Well, that's a foul too.
And that's Holden. And a two-shot foul, three on Cornelius. Now you put the big Hammett on the line. Out of the Netherlands.
Well, they got a good shot out of it. Hammett comes in, and there you see Holden, no question. He had him right across the face at the foul. Hammett has not made a free throw this year in two tries.
81-78. A two-point UofL lead. We've got 4 minutes exactly left, and Hammett can make it a one-point game.
You know, we haven't seen Brian Hopgood at all in the game. I don't know if we won the final 4 minutes or not, but he could bang in there pretty good with Hammett. But Denny Crum, I think, likes what he sees from his club.
There's a steal. Brandon stole it and scored. This game is now in favor of LSU, 82-81, with O'Neal on the bench.
Well, maybe it provided a lift for him. Sometimes adversity brings the best out of you.
Well, big turnovers by the Cardinals back to back, and Singleton puts it in. 84-81, LSU by three. Timeout, Louisville. We'll be back to Baton Rouge after this timeout.
Light Ultra's Guide to the 90s, Chapter 5, Enlightenment. The enlightened consumer of the 90s will have a heightened sense of awareness.
This is beer.
He'll know what he likes.
I like beer.
What he'll like is the ultra-smooth taste of Light Ultra from Miller.
Smooth? Smooth?
He'll be more perceptive.
77 calories.
And man's state of enlightenment will give rise to new ways of thinking.
You thinking what I'm thinking?
Yeah, I'm thinking. I'll have another.
Light Ultra from Miller. You gotta move with the times.
Since Shaquille O'Neal fouled out, LSU has outscored Louisville 6-0.
And David, here you see the turnover. This is the basket that LSU goes in front with by one. And then they're going to get the benefit of some Louisville turnovers again. Sullivan forced the pass. And the break by LSU. And wide open was Williamson, or check that. There was Singleton that put it in.
Down by three, Louisville with the basketball. Legree is back in the backcourt, along with Everett Sullivan, the starting guards. The entire starting lineup is on the court for U of L. The clock inside 3 minutes. They throw it inside, whistle and a foul. That's against Caesar, number 34 on Caesar, I believe.
Now you can know why they call this place the Deaf Dome, because it's getting very, very loud. Because LSU trying to come back. If you join us late, O'Neal is fouled out of the game. And LSU was behind at the time, but they've come back and taken the lead. And those words on the wall are becoming a reality here in Baton Rouge.
Dwayne Morton. Martin with a steal, out of bounds, LSU basketball.
LSU really turned it up a notch since O'Neal went out. This has been a gutty effort by the Tigers.
We got a lot of time, 2 minutes and 50 seconds to go. LSU holding an 84-81 lead. The Cardinals have hit a drought. Outscored 6-0. Williamson driving over Legree.
Sorry.
That's an offensive foul on Williamson.
Now, Miner did a good job of stepping in and taking it at a critical time. Player control, so it'll go out of bounds to Louisville. 20 turnovers now in the Tigers.
Everett Sullivan to inbounds it. Louisville still trails. No change in the score. 84-81. 2:32 on the scoreboard. Legree, Brandon can pick your pocket. Now Brandon double-teamed in the lane. Legree goes for the save. Out of bounds, LSU.
Louisville's made three just crucial turnovers trying to get something going offensively.
Updating our scoreboard, Americal scoreboard, Kentucky by four. Late in the first half, later on. 2 minutes and 19 seconds left here in Baton Rouge. Troy Smith in and Miner out.
Went some rebounding in here.
Smith in double figure scoring. You get more scoring punch in. Miners had but 2 points tonight, and that field goal was in the first half. LSU by three. Hammock. Now Legree on the break. Does not fall, and they call Legree with a foul.
Fresh mistake that time, I think, David. He's not made a whole lot of them, considering he's a true freshman, but there was a case where he'd been better advised to back it out, and he definitely makes the contact and gives credit for Singleton picking it up.
Hammock drops it to Williamson. 2:10 to go. 3-point LSU lead. Everett Sullivan guarding Brandon. Brandon threw it in.
Louisville's just not been able to get anything offensively. Too many turnovers.
They're now down by five with a minute 48 to go. Holden, he's fouled.
Well, the crowd reacts on every play. They've really picked it up. Dale Brown has created a lot of excitement here in Bayou Country in the last 20 years, and they're into it now.
Caesar's fourth foul. Al, as the crowd will quiet down with a minute 39 to go, Louisville is trailing LSU 86-81. Total of 41 turnovers in this game. And the foul shooting, it has not been good all year for the Cardinals. It's not that good tonight.
Now, Morton missed two earlier when I think it was a three-point game. Holden misses right there.
We got a five-point game. And Holden hits that one. 4 point, 86-82 lead, LSU.
An 8-2 run for the Tigers since O'Neal fouled out of the game. That tells you how that adversity has really helped LSU. Denny Crum now is looking over the stat sheet. He did that just a moment ago to figure out who to foul in this situation.
All right, Dwayne Morton got some instructions from Coach Denny Crum. Brandon gets some from Dale Brown. Between these two coaches, about 800 victories.
Yeah.
O'Neal has got the best seat in the house.
He's a big cheerleader, isn't he?
His teammates playing very well down the stretch while he's not in there. Here's Williamson. Maurice Williamson throws a brick.
They haven't had mortar on him. Well, he's from the Chicago area. Michael Jordan likes to keep that tongue out of his mouth. He does the same thing a little bit.
Easy layup by Williamson. 6-point lead.
The effort by Williamson.
Inside a minute and a half to go. Legree with Brandon on his back. Timeout, says Denny Crum. Morton drives to the basket and gets the basket. It's a 4-point game. A minute 12 to go. 88-84. LSU. Holden goes for the steal and fouls. And that'll be four on Cornelius Holden.
It's been a lot of little bitty things, David, that have been a difference with the LSU effort in this game. Williamson missed two free throws, and there's no way that the shooter should ever get his own rebound and be able to put it back in, unless it's a freak thing where it kicks all the way back out. But Williamson, big, big play for LSU.
And Caesar with big free throws. He's hit 2 3-pointers in this half, has 15 points in the game. A freshman. Missed that one, and Legree will grab this rebound. Louisville down by five, 89-84. Legree around the seven-footer, hit it. 7 points keep Legree, 89-86. Three-point LSU lead, 55 seconds to go.
About a 10-second difference between the game clock and the shot clock.
Sullivan fouling on Brandon.
This guy had missed a free throw all year coming into this game. He's not the one you want to foul.
He's missed one tonight, 4 out of 5. So Brandon, the sophomore.
That's a big miss there.
Does not connect. There are 40 seconds left.
Of course, now both teams with 10 fouls, so both teams will have 2 free throws in the final 40 seconds.
Brandon hitting 1 out of 2, 90-86.
Louisville needs 2 possessions, and they're going to talk about it.
And Denny Crum up off the bench to signal timeout for Louisville. And so the Cardinals will huddle with 36 seconds to go. And Don, they're down by 4 points to LSU. And the difference with O'Neal out of the game has not been noticeable.
No question about it. Matter of fact, I think it's made LSU play even better. As we mentioned, the adversity, I think, has really helped them. Denny Crum's going to match some strategy. Let's see if we can eavesdrop.
I want to run it center out.
Get it, they foul it.
Go 2-1-D, 2-1-D.
Yeah, that's, you can't get it from a better source than Denny Crum. Great job to hear what he was thinking about doing.
And try to get the ball to Everett Sullivan and Brewer, the two shooters he's got in the game. Sullivan with 4 3-pointers tonight and Brewer with 3. And 36 seconds here in Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
Try to get it to Sullivan if they possibly can.
The shot's open for Legree. Sullivan missed it. Holden got it, and he's fouled. Big play by Cornelius Holden. A one-point game.
That's when you miss O'Neal in the game.
Two-point game, 90-88. 12 seconds clicked off the clock. 24 left as Holden will be at the line.
Big, big rebound. Legree with the miss. Sullivan missed the tip. The follow and the foul.
It's a one-point game now. They whistled the foul very quickly to stop it with 1 second off of the clock. 23 to go.
I don't think they really wanted to foul there. Obviously didn't need to, but yet... One thing about it, if you're going to foul and put him at the line, he sure didn't waste much time. And
just 1 second clicked off the clock. And so at the line, it'll be Brandon. And Brandon is probably not the guy you want up there at the line. If you're Louisville. O'Neal is out. Caesar with 4. Williamson with 3. Holden with 4. Minor, Legree, and Brewer all with 3. Here's Brandon's foul shot.
Now, Shaq was cheering a little bit earlier. He's just kind of taking it all in right now.
Brandon makes it a 91-89 game.
Get out. Oh.
92-89, 3-point lead, 22 to go. Legree will take the 3, and he didn't get it. Everett Sullivan will flip around and put it up. Foul inside. It's on Brewer.
I think they're going to call it on Williamson.
Williamson and Brewer both went after one another.
Yeah. They pointed to Holden to go to the line. Well... What was it? Notre Dame in this crucial situation, the only road game earlier. Here you see Legree taking a 3. I thought they rushed that a little bit. Sullivan actually even had more time right here, but he spins and takes a very difficult shot. And then they get the Williamson foul and Holden to go to the line. Only 8 seconds left.
Eight seconds left and a 3-point lead for LSU.
Lane violation.
Lane violation against LSU. Holden can step back, gain his composure, regain his composure, and go back to the line. Dale Brown going to make a lot of complaining here. It's been a bugaboo all year, free throw shooting. Dale Brown calls a timeout. They'll make Holden think about the next one. 8 seconds to go. A three-point lead for LSU. They led by four at halftime, had a 10-point lead in the first half. Denny Crum now with 8 seconds to match.
If it's a miss and we can rebound it, I want three rebounders in there. Do your thing. Screen across, the other guy go around. You won't have to kick it out. We got to kick it out and shoot the three.
That's the last 8 seconds of strategy. Next telecast we'll have Houston at Louisville on Thursday, January the 2nd, live at 8 p.m. and a special pregame show to precede the game at 7:30 on WDRB Fox 41. The Cardinals, a week from tonight, of course, have Kentucky at Rupp Arena. No timeouts left for LSU. 8 seconds to go. And it's a 1-2 point game, 92-90.
Now, if they don't get the steal, they'll foul immediately, like right now.
They do. That's Morton's fourth, and there's 1 second off the clock.
Well, you heard Denny Crum map out that strategy. They wanted to allow Williamson to get the ball in his hand. They did that, and they fouled immediately when they didn't get the steal.
And kept Brandon off the foul line. Now Williamson, who's been up to the foul line twice tonight and missed both of them.
Yeah, it's been a great game, and LSU comes back to Louisville next year, so they'll be facing their own Death Dome in Freedom Hall. Good series. They'll see that guy back most likely. He says he's going to come back.
Two shots.
Oh!
That's a big miss now.
He's 0 for 3.
Louisville should get the rebound because LSU has everybody back. The only people in the lane are four red-shirted Cardinals.
Louisville has a timeout left. LSU has none.
Rebound.
It's still a two-point lead. Here we go.
Somebody's got to shoot it.
They got it. Keith Lickery has won the game on a last-second three-point shot. It's all over.
The Death Dome has become totally solid because the freshman Keith LeGreen, who in a couple of crucial fit situations threw it away, but the guy is a Major League Baseball player, and that's a clutch hit, and I'm talking about a triple, a three-pointer to win the game in Baton Rouge.
And that was probably outside of 30 feet as Keith LeGreen, a freshman, and let's look at it again. A three-pointer at the buzzer.
LeGreen
way outside.
And Holden almost didn't get rid of it. But that was a three-pointer that'll be remembered for a long, long time. Here it goes. The miss. That's 0 for 4 at the line for Williamson. Now watch Holden here. He's looking for somebody. He's looking to Sullivan. Gets it to LeGreen. I mean, we're talking an NBA plus three-pointer, and that's nothing but, as Joe Dean would say, sorry, Joe, string music.
And a victory for Louisville to run its record to 6-0. And we'll be back to Baton Rouge in just a minute.
We built the new Camry with many exotic materials, including the one you see here, the road. You see, by putting insulating panels made from asphalt in the new Camry, we were able to help keep something else out. Noise. We just couldn't leave well enough alone.
Test drive the all-new Toyota Camry. Roomier, safer, quieter, and more powerful at your Toyota dealer now.
Brad Walker chose to have RK, an outpatient surgery to correct nearsightedness. He chose the most experienced RK team in the area. That's important for getting the best results and made RK the best investment Brad ever made. Today, he enjoys improved vision without relying on glasses or contacts. This makes Brad's life easier on and off the job. Like over 500,000 others, you too may be able to enjoy the benefits of RK. Call today and let the John Kenyon Eye Center bring world-class eye care home to you.
We told you not to go away. This would be a barn burner, and it was. It went to the last. Papa John Pizza play of the game.
No question about it. Here you see Williamson ends up 0-4 at the line. Rebound, Morton up to Holden. The clock is running down, running down. What's Holden going to do? He gets it to Legree. Keith with the long three-pointer. And Mamma Mia, that one has extra cheese and sausage on there. Papa John's play of the game. Legree, the freshman, with the game winner here at LSU.
And so the Cardinals come out of Tiger Country here in Baton Rouge with a thrilling come-from-behind win, 93-92. And the strategy you were able to watch it being mapped by Denny Crum went according to script.
No question about it. We heard Denny Crum map it out, and it worked to perfection.
He kept Brandon off the foul line, put Williamson there. He missed two. And Louisville with a dramatic win tonight, Legree's long three-pointer. Wish everybody a Merry Christmas. Executive producers of Cardinal Basketball are Gary Bockhorst and Roy C. Hamlin, Jr. Tonight's game produced by Chris DeMayo. Our director, Lou Rainone. This is David Sullivan along with Don Russell. Happy holidays, everybody, and so long from Baton Rouge.